Every summer, my horse and other horses at the barn start with slobbers from red clover. Is there anything that can help slow down the amount of drooling without limiting the horse's turnout?
So I think I'm going to have some ideas for her. I think the answer might be yes. But first, I want to make sure that everybody who's watching is on the same page.
Yes.
So slobbers is the name that we give to this condition we see in horses. When they eat a type of plant in the family of the legumes. Legumes are, you think of alfalfa, mm-hmm. All right? Clovers, I think she mentioned red clover.
Yep.
There's white clover, there's alsike, there's, and then my favorite legume, lespediza.
Of course.
So you, these types of plants, these legumes, when there's certain conditions, like high humidity, a fungus can grow on them. Mm. And the fungus produces a mycotoxin called slaframine.
Slaframine, okay.
And so slaframine poisoning is also referred to as slobbers.
Okay, gotcha.
And slaframine poisoning sounds terrible.
Yes.
This is mostly a nuisance. It's not really a health threat to horses. It's a cosmetic thing. Now, if your horse is in the barn and you're riding it every day, it's annoying because they can leave big puddles of saliva. But if you're showing,
yeah,
it's more of a, so I can understand.
Not a good look, yeah.
It's not a good look. So the things that she can do are things that you do in the pasture. And so she may or may not have influence over these, but I'll just read these. You can, and some of these are long-term and some are short-term, but overseed with grass and make sure that you're planting no more than about 40% of the legumes. And I think I say this too a lot every time. Talk to your county extension agent. They know your area, your geographic area, intimately well. They know pasture management, they know weather, they know toxic plants. They know all that stuff.
Yeah.
That's their job. So
I don't think we
use them as much as we should. You can learn as a horse owner to check legume or clover leaves for this fungus. And so they'll look like black spots or black rings, maybe just brown or gray. And like I said, they appear in times of high humidity, but really anytime the pasture is stressed. So pasture gets stressed from too much water, but also too little water. So periods of drought, it's
of course
always stressed. And also overgrazing, mm-hmm. If a pasture is eaten down. That said, one of the best things you can do to reduce the how bad this problem gets in horses is to keep the pasture mowed to about no more than 3 to 4 inches high.
3 to 4 inches, okay.
Because regrowth tends not to harbor the fungus.
Oh.
So if you keep your pasture low, you'll have less of the fungus and less of the slaframine.
Interesting, okay.
So that's something you can do like right then. The phrase that your county extension agent may share is fertilize, rest, and rotate. And you want to fertilize the grass.
Okay.
Because the clovers and the alfalfas, they take over if the grass doesn't have what it needs to grow more.
So you want the grass to keep growing and get provided what
Yeah,
it
otherwise
needs.
The legumes will tend to take over, the bullies. And then, but resting the pasture so it's not stressed.
Mm-hmm.
And one way to rest it is to rotate. So if you have two pastures, you can use one and not use one. And that's good because you're letting it grow, letting it even out again. You can mow it, you can remove the manure,
mm-hmm.
So I'm thinking about parasites. in last resort, then you have to pull the horses, and I know this was not what you wanted to do, pull the horses and put them on a dry lot, feed them hay. Now, hay, if it's made with legumes, can also have slaframine in it. However, like vitamin E and some other things, slaframine also degrades through time as the hay is cut and stored. So it will be less than the living grass.
Okay, so those are definitely some options depending if, she's boarding your horse, you might have a little bit less control over the pasture, but if nothing else, you can always do dry lot with hay if that worst case comes to worst case.
And the last thing I would say is don't assume that just because your horse is hypersalivating that it is slobbers. Maybe the first time, unless you experience this every year and you know your horse has it, and not every horse will do it.
Mm-hmm.
Some are more sensitive to slaframine, and it also it depends on your preference for grazing. Like if you prefer to eat grass, you're probably not going to run into this.
Yeah.
But if you're a clover seeker, then you're getting a heavier load of it.
But have the vet out at least the first time and make sure that slobbers is what you're dealing with and it's not choke, which is very serious and could be life-threatening, that it's not some sort of trauma or a dental disease or there's other things your vet can rule out. But really, it's a chronic over time thing. Mm. Every day you see it. So that's one of the clues that it's slobbers, but your vet can help you, narrow down and say, yep, it's for sure, confirm it.
Awesome. Well, hopefully those tips were helpful for you, and let us know how your horse does with some of these management tips.